Alright guys, welcome back to the channel. If you're new, my name is Bobby. Guys, first and foremost, thank you from the bottom of my heart. Thank you so much for your warm, welcoming wishes, your comments on my last video. It was more than I could ever ask for. It was more than I could hope for. It was absolutely amazing to see. And guys, as I told you in the comment section, I missed you guys too. And especially after seeing all of those comments, man, I realized I missed you more than I actually remembered. It was amazing. Thank you very much. All right, enough of that. Now, in today's video, I went vegan. Yes, it's not clickbait, guys. I went vegan for Lent. Exactly. As you know, if you've been following Bobby's perspective, I returned to Christian Orthodoxy. And with that, I wanted to fast for Easter. So now, for the people that don't know, there is a slight difference in the fasting practice if you compare Orthodox Christian fasting practices to Catholic or Protestant customs. So let me explain what that means. Basically, we're eating plant-based, with the exception of certain seafood. Fish is not allowed, just certain seafood that doesn't have a spine, such as shrimp or mussel or oysters. All of that is good to go. The rest is vegan. No dairy, no eggs, no meat, no nothing. Now, let me give you my review of how it felt being vegan again. Guys, the first day wasn't too bad. Honestly, the food didn't taste that bad. However, what was striking to me is the constant hunger. It was unbelievable. When you're eating meat, especially raw meat, you never feel full, you never feel heavy, but you feel satiated, you feel happy, you feel satisfied. Those three words are a mystery to long-term vegans. They already forgot how it feels to be satiated. That was the first thing that went out of the window. The second day, my digestion got wrecked. But this is something that I was already expecting. This is nothing new. My digestion got wrecked, but this constant hunger started leading to depression. And I know, I already hear the vegans,
you didn't eat enough, you need more calories.
Yeah, sure. Guys, I basically replaced every single meal that I used to eat beforehand and even tried to replicate certain macros. However, as always, big surprise, it did not work. Day 3, full set depression, no joy for life, absolutely drained, paranoid even, anxious, mood disorders all over the place. Yes, I know, nothing new, but I had to see it for myself again. And it was amazing to see how fast it kicked in. It didn't take a couple of days. However, what I realized during that period is that I felt like that for 4 years without realizing it, because I was so brainwashed and so detached from my body. I didn't even listen to my body anymore, which was suffering so badly. Absolutely terrible. This is why we call veganism the doctrine of the devils, because it is shocking how far you can go into this doctrine and neglect your body totally. Absolutely sad to see. Anyways, this time, with the spiritual pursuit at hand, I realized now I am suffering. As Jesus Christ suffered for us on the cross, this is how we suffer during the time of Lent. We are abstaining from the flesh. We are distancing ourselves from our carnal desires. That is the whole point. That makes sense. That is a spiritual practice. However, when you do that as a vegan, with no plan, with no higher purpose, no higher goal at hand, what are you doing? I was sacrificing my body for 4 years straight to nothing, to nobody, right? To false idols. And let me tell you guys, everything becomes a false idol, or can become a false idol. Animals,
the environment,
whatever, pick and choose. This is what we see with vegans. Physically, they are of course sacrificing their health. If you don't get that in 2020, you're a lost cause. There is no help for you. Veganism is destruction. Veganism is not the species-specific diet. I can't believe that I'm still talking about this. But it's true. Anyways, during the fasting period, during Lent, it all made sense. I understood why we fast. I understood why we go through discomfort. What the whole point of it is, right? Our sacrifice. In life, you have to sacrifice, right? You go to the gym instead of sitting on the couch. Why do you do that? You're sacrificing your time. You're sacrificing your family. You're sacrificing the taste pleasure, right? In order to achieve something greater. And this is what we see, right? This is a spiritual practice, a true spiritual practice. But if it is abused as the vegans practice it, then of course you are sacrificing yourself, you're destroying your body for false idols, false idol worship. This is what we see. So now, enough screaming and shouting. Let me get to the point. Guys, how did I feel at Pascha? How did I feel after reintroducing those beautiful animal foods? How did that make me feel? Guys, it took one meal of steak tartare to return to normality. Can you imagine that? It took one single meal of steak tartare to bring me back to normality. The depression started vanishing. I felt centered again. I felt normal again. I felt like myself again. All of those demons disappeared. It is amazing when you truly understand what human nutrition is. It is mind-boggling to me that I stayed on the vegan diet for so long. But to give you a little background story here, I was traveling during that time. I was removed from my family. I was removed from my hometown, right? I didn't have a normal environment any longer. Nobody held me accountable, right? I was left on my own. And I failed to see and understand how much I was suffering until the bitter end. Until I totally destroyed myself. Teeth were rotting out. Muscles were ripping apart. I see it to this very day in the vegan community. People get injured left and right all the time. Nobody recovers. Anyways, I said I'm not gonna rant and rave anymore, guys. I'm getting passionate about this. I forgot how it felt to talk about the doctrine of devils. It feels good to let it all out because we want food sovereignty. We don't want to be controlled. We don't want your forced vaccines. We don't want any of that. We don't want your soy slop. We want proper food, proper meat, because we are humans. Simple as that. Anyways, after reintroducing those foods, you see how necessary they are. Unbelievable. Even during the time of Lent, when I would go vegan for a couple of days, and then I would eat at least some shrimp or some mussel. Oh, the feeling, the satisfaction. Not as good as raw meat, of course not, but at least a little bit of relief, a little bit of well-being. I just felt like I was grinding my gears. Absolutely no lubrication, nothing. The vegans will scream and shout, mucus-free diet. A mucus-free diet destroys the cell membranes. It dehydrates you. It wrecks you. Unbelievable. Guys, please, Come on! Wake up! What is this? 2020, in the Orthodox community, we understand what veganism is, and I wish I would have fasted prior to this, prior to going vegan, because then I would understand what it truly means to go vegan. I would see the contrast. For anybody that is contemplating and thinking about going vegan, please go on a trial first, fast, with a purpose, with a higher spiritual goal, and see how you feel then, and how you feel after reintroducing the animal foods. Don't sacrifice yourself for false idols, guys. Don't do this to yourself. Don't do this to your families. Don't do this to us humans. All right, guys. But this is it for today's video. Enough with this rant. Guys, if you liked it, leave it a thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed already, please do so. And let me tell you one more time, thank you, thank you, thank you for so much beautiful, positive feedback. I feel truly welcomed. I feel truly blessed to be able to express myself in front of such an amazing audience. Thank you from the bottom of my heart. May God bless you all. And as always, much love and peace.